leads to happiness. This is broadly our agenda for the day. We'll see how it unfolds. Maybe as you would like it, we will go follow that path. That would be better. Collectively, let's move in that path. In fact, I said collectively, any learning that happens, it has to be through both the people who are learning, those who are facilitating. There is a wonderful verse, maybe we can start with it. It is from the Taittiriya Upanishad, which says, how should we learn? What should be the approach to learn? When somebody is saying something, the teacher and the learner, both should be in a state. That state matters most. And that state, I think it's a very familiar verse from Taittiriya Upanishad. I'll just take you through that. It may be there, I remember it, but in case it doesn't come instantaneously. It goes like this. Sahana bhavatu, sahano bhunaktu, sahvirja karavavahe, tejasvin avaditam astu, ma vit visavahe. The whole essence is sahana bhavatu, that let we be protected. When we are in a state of learning, let us be protected. Protection means we are not concerned about anything that's going to disturb us, that's going to threaten us. Because in a state of threat, we cannot learn. That's what neuroscience also suggests. There is either a state of survival or a state of growth. Both do not normally coexist. So when there is a state of survival, I am in a state of crisis. Learning doesn't happen. I am in a state of moving away, fight or flight mode. So learning cannot happen very smoothly. So we need to feel protected. So we are in a very wonderful, secure, lovely, natural place. So we are that way very secure. We should thank Almighty for that. Sahana Vunaktu, let us be nourished. Collectively we learn. Sahavaisya Karavavane, the energy that should be created, that should enrich all of us, both as we are sharing with you, as you are processing within, let that energy enrich all of us. And when we are interacting, let not conflict come in and disturb us. Conflict may arise, but should not disturb us. It should rather move in a direction of our higher journey. And we all should be enriched through this whole process. That's what this wonderful verse suggests. And from there, let's start about the emotion regulation part. So in the emotion, we had a lot of discussion. I'll take you back to the gorilla aspect. We saw something and we didn't see that. That's quite fascinating. And so attention was one of the profound thing when we observe things. Now, is emotion also important apart from when we go through certain emotion? Like I know I'm supposed to, sometime I'm happy, sometime I'm not so happy. Maybe I'm afraid, maybe I'm feeling guilty, maybe I'm feeling a little uncomfortable. Some anxiety is there. Apart from this, in fact, of every moment when we are appreciating things, when we are looking at things, emotion does play a very important role. To appreciate this, I'll take you through a very interesting story. Not a story, it is rather an observation, an ailment. It's called the crabgrass syndrome. And it has been an enigma for the neuroscientists, for the people who go through it, and people who are relatives of those people, the sufferers. What is happening in this way? And Dr. V.S. Ramachandran, who is an Indian origin scientist, and now he's an American citizen, called the rock star of neuroscience now. He came across this and found something profound, why this happens. Let me first narrate what is crabgrass syndrome. Now, one individual who came to Ramachandran later, he met with an accident. The accident happened and he recovered. It was a brain injury, he recovered. But one thing very unusual happened to him. He goes to his house, sees his mother. He says, she appears to be my mother, but she is an imposter. She is not my mother. She is so similar to my mother, but she is not my mother. She looks so close to my brother, but he is not my brother. He is somebody who is pretending to be my brother. Father, friends, all of them, he started saying this kind of things. And typically this happened when there is the bonding was strong, like mother, father, brother, siblings, but not as much with somebody who is not as known. Maybe a distant friend would not be a problem. So they were thoroughly confused. What is happening? He's saying he looks like this, but he's not that. What is the issue? They started explaining in various fashions, but actually they were not great explanations. What finally they found out is a part of the brain known as the fusiform gyrus, which gives us or helps us recognizing faces. If I see like this, then I say, yes, he's Mr. Tomasu. Because his face is like this, I have seen him yesterday, and my brain has created an impression of his face by connecting different bits of it. Nose is like this, eyes are like this, there. So I don't actually cognitively look at nose as aisa hai, toh ye Mr. Himanshu hai, ye Mr. Mahapatra hai. I am not distinguishing that fashion. My brain quickly conjures of the entire input and creates a face, and that part is done by a part called the fusiform gyrus. So that was fine with this individual. So he was recognizing he's my mother, or he's my father, he's my friend. What they found is one connect, one line, one neuropathway was severed. It was not there, it was severed. And interestingly, that neuropathway was to the emotional center called the limbic system, typically the amygdala. So what was happening with this individual is, he was getting all the cognitive input. He looks like my mother. My mother hai. But mother ko dekhne se jo feeling hota hai, the feeling that arises through that visionary sensation, it doesn't happen. So that connection, when it is severed, I say, she is my mother, but she is pretending. She cannot be my mother because I'm not getting that emotional input to support when I see my mother or my father or my brother. So emotion, they later found, it's not just one thing that gives us the perception that we get out of any observation. Emotion has a very strong linkage. It has a strong bearing of what we get as a final perception of what we observe. And if we are emotionally healthy, we create a more profound emotional tone inside, our observation also improves in a great way. So we can see things, we can appreciate them at much deeper level, and we can probably respond to things in a much, much better, deeper level. So this is a story to say how
but profoundly. Without that emotional connect also, we can recognize.
We can recognize, yeah. But the recognition, when we say recognize, it has got multiple flavors. Some of the flavors are the vision which has come in. Some of the flavors are the sound that we see. Some of the flavors are the tone that we recognize, the way somebody, like somebody, let's say, it is like this. Somebody who comes to you, who is so close to your, let's say, wife. Yesterday we were having a chat with Dr. Rana Chetri, who said that there are seven people who are so identical. So that's what is a belief. So somebody is very identical like your father, but you're sure he's not your father. Because although he's absolutely like him, but there is something which your mind knows, which you know, that he, although just appears like that, but he's something different. So that differentiation was felt by this individual. So close to my mother, but still he's not, or she's not.
Now what I mean to say is, it doesn't happen with our office colleagues. You need not connect emotionally.
Yeah, that's why they say this non-recognition happens with closer ones. When you know somebody less, that emotional the charge is so less, so you say, no, he is my colleague. So no problem in recognizing colleagues and distant friends, distant relatives. But the moment it is a closer thing,
emotional,
the emotions. Even in case of his pet, he was saying he is not my pet. He appears to be my pet. Because it's very close to the pet. Though he recognizes that pet, the dog, so he was refusing to accept that he is my dog. So what the essential thing I was trying to convey is, so emotion is very powerful, and it is probably a responsibility to take care of this. This can destroy us, destroy the individual, destroy all of us, if we do not use it properly, or it can create a wonderful being out of us. So let's look at emotion. I'll not take much of time. I think it's 9:30. We'll take about 30 minutes to take you through this journey of what are the things that we can do so that we can create a better emotional life, and we can manage our emotional life better. So I'll take you through 4 or 5 steps. One is the step number one. It's called situation selection. Should I write or simple steps? You can just write. Few of them are a little tricky. You need any extra notebook? I think we have some. We can provide notebooks also. Or we can do notebook. The first one is called situation selection. And this is a preemptive step, or this is more of a preemptive technique. Situation selection is...
The earlier what you said was Capgras syndrome.
That's,
or Capgras?
Yeah, that's just a story. Capgras syndrome. Capgras is the scientist who first discovered this ailment.
CAP.
Yeah, Capgras. Capgras syndrome. So first one is the situation selection. Situation selection is, we know in a day we could have gone for a simple exercise of reflection. In a day we go through different events, and each of the event either gives us positive emotion or it can give us some negative emotion. Somebody I see, I am not happy, I am angry. Ek subordinate ko dekhte hain to wo usko dekhne se hi lagta hai ठीक नहीं है तो आई नॉट फील दैट गुड समबडी एल्स आई मीट एंड आई फील वेरी एनर्जाइज्ड सो फाइंडिंग आउट विच आर द इवेंट्स विच आर गिविंग मी सम नेगेटिव इमोशंस सो आइडेंटिफाइंग इन माय डेली लाइफ और इन अ वीक और सो व्हाट आर दोज इवेंट्स विच गिव मी दैट नेगेटिव इमोशन एंड जस्ट कीप अ टैब ऑफ दोज कीपिंग अ टैब ऑफ दोज मीन्स So finding out this is something, if my wife says this word, I feel little agitated. Or my husband says like this, I feel agitated. So just keeping a track of those things. Which are the things which are leading to some sort of negativity? So once we select those things, then we say, please avoid the ones or the events which you can, which are not affecting your responsibility domain. Which are not affecting your responsibility domain, please avoid those. I'll just take you through one thing. I think I should tell you why we feel negative. Which are the instances which lead to a negative thought or negative feeling? So we should know what are those things which lead to negative feeling. Again, this mapping may help all of us. Yesterday we had a discussion that 6.5 million years we were there in the jungle. So many of the aspects of the experiences that we carried, our genes have memorized those. And five of the things which are which lead to some negative emotion, and this is by an English scientist. He's not a scientist, he's more of, he studied a lot on neuroscience and found out that why negative emotions arise in human beings. And he talks about something called SCARF. S-C-A-R-F, first letter of 5 different things. S stands for status. The moment I find my status is being challenged, negative emotion will arise. I am facing a lot at this point in time. My son is in class 11. Now he has become, he is feeling like a man, not become a man completely, but still, that status, he has a, the moment I say don't do this, I am affecting the status that he expects, as if I am downgrading him. So the moment I start saying, aisa mat karo, or aisa karo, I am directing somebody, he feels, who are you? He doesn't say that. It's very humble that way, doesn't say that. But internally, I can sense the resistance that's coming. Who are you to tell that? And it happens with all of us. Boss says something, main jaisa bolta hu, aisa hi karna chahiye. Promotion nahi hua, my status is getting affected. Somebody is saying that you are good or you are bad, my status is getting affected. The moment that status is getting affected, the negative emotions start coming in. The status is elevated, positive emotions come. So status is one thing which is very important. Which, if we can see why I am feeling bad at this point, is it that somebody said to me something which has led to little decrease in my status position? If that has happened, that is the reason why this is happening. So first one is status. Second one is C, that is certainty. It is certainty about what is going to, my expectation is going to happen or not happen. I have an expectation my son should get into, say, engineering or medical. This event, is it leading to some uncertainty to that outcome? Then I will be uncomfortable. Time pe mujhe rail station mein pahunchna hai. If train, my car is not coming on time or my wife is delaying the thing, the uncertainty creeps in. So I start feeling agitated. Somebody suddenly says, "Arey, wo packing nahi ho paaya." So you feel so agitated. "Kya kar rahi ho ye tum?" So we start getting that agitation because the uncertainty seeps in. Uncertainty we cannot handle otherwise. So negative emotion comes in. The third one, they call it autonomy, we discussed yesterday. The moment my freedom is infringed, we had recently had a biometric system in most of our plants. The installation was so difficult because people have a sense of their autonomy being breached. It's not that many of them would have been coming before 8 and going after 5. That was not the issue. Who are you to tell that I'll come at 8 and 9 or and leave at 5? That autonomy sense, that my autonomy, my freedom is being infringed, can lead to a serious emotional trauma. So that's the third one. Autonomy, the moment we feel my freedom is being snatched away, mujhe koi baandh ke rakh raha hai, not physically but at least mentally, somebody else is dictating what I should do, my negative emotion can come. So that's autonomy. Next one is relatedness or relationship. I remember in my childhood, my mother would say, "Tum agar ye nahi karoge, main ek ghanta tak tumhare saath baat nahi karunga." That was so traumatic. Ek ghanta tak mummy baat nahi karegi. That relationship, it gives a sense, it's a traumatic feel. That my relationship is getting severed if I'm not going to do this thing. Somebody says, "Tum agar aisa nahi karoge," ya nahi bhi bole, kisi ko hum kuch bol diye. Yesterday she was saying about guilt. Kisi ko kuch bol diye. The guilt actually arises from, this is going to affect my relationship. And the moment that comes, I feel so agitated inside. And it keeps coming back, keeps coming back. So again, that relationship, anything that leads to any disturbance to a relationship can lead to negative emotions. And final one, F is for fairness. Whenever we feel unfair things are happening, yesterday we were talking to Agarwal Sahab, many a times we feel that he was not deserving, but he got the promotion. I don't know whether that feel is right, wrong, or whatever, but the moment that comes in, negative emotions come in. Raste mein mujhe kaise, how he can drive like this? I am driving so well. So when unfairness sense comes, then also negative emotion comes. These are the 5 things you remember, because next thing that we are going to discuss would need this. So there are 5 things from which negative emotions can come in. So first one, we discussed the first thing, which is a preemptive one, is called situation selection, selecting the appropriate situations. The second step is, or rather the second technique that normally we use for emotional channelization is called attention redeployment. Human attention, as we have already seen, is very powerful. It's called selective attention, very, very powerful. So attention redeployment is, the moment something is coming in and disturbing our self and we are emotionally disturbed, how to change that attention and put it somewhere else. And this needs practice and preparedness, that if this kind of emotion comes, what will I do? Like if my status is getting affected, what should be my recourse? Where should I deploy my attention? Attention redeployment means, I have a problem and I am feeling some emotion. Now I will do something else. I will start thinking about something else or doing some other activity which will remove or take my attention to the other. And typically, I'll give you an example. Whenever I also love watching cricket matches, and especially India-Pakistan or some very rivalry kind of team is there, naturally the emotions are there. And India loses, I used to have sleepless nights. And many of us, I think, we are like that. And later I found, what's the fun? Why should I have such kind of sleepless night? But you can't help it. It just comes. India loses and you are having it. कुछ नहीं मन कर बड़ा बेकार लगता है उसके बाद दिन खराब हो जाता है नाउ देन व्हेन आई वेंट थ्रू दिस स्कार्फ मॉडल आई वाज जस्ट एनालाइजिंग व्हाई आई एम फीलिंग लाइक दिस वन इंडिया लूजिंग टू पाकिस्तान द स्टेटस माय अटैचमेंट टू द कंट्री एंड माय अटैचमेंट टू क्रिकेट टीम ऑफ इंडिया एंड माय स्टेटस एक्चुअली इज गोइंग डाउन सिग्निफिकेंटली दैट्स द वन रीजन व्हाई आई एम फीलिंग सो अनकंफर्टेबल
स्टेटस और सर्टेनिटी
सर्टेंटी हैज हैपन सर्टेंटी अगर आउट हो जाता है तो सर्टेंटी कोई आउट हो गया सो आउटकम इज अनलाइकली टू हैपन सो दिस सर्टेंटी ऑफ इंडियाज विनिंग इज माई एक्सपेक्टेशन उस समय आउट होने के समय वो होगा बट जब हार गया मान लीजिए बैटिंग चल रहा है और 50 रन है 3 विकेट बचा है 1 विकेट गिर गया सो योर सर्टेंटी वुड एक्चुअली मेक यू वेरी डिस्टर्ब कि अभी certainty of getting to my objective has come down so low 2 wickets 550 runs 10 overs so unlikely so you feel because of that uncertainty anxiety would come but when things have happened India have lost let's say
status.
So it's status you have actually lost your position the same thing happened when we don't get a promotion the same thing happened when we maybe somebody misbehaves in a meeting boss shouts my status actually in front of others it has gone down so when status is affected what should I do and I typically found when my status is affected if I go to read a book didn't work again going back to india pakistan match kaise hara wo trophy kaise leke chale gaye whatever so need to discover for yourself for me what worked is the moment such thing which are affecting my status came in, I started doing one thing, going out, going for a jogging, going for a walk, which is very physical, which is little strenuous, little kind of, it can make yourself little painful, not if not painful, at least it's a bit strenuous. So there the body strain probably will take out those negative emotion and easily channel it out. So that worked for me, you have to discover yourself. So why I said status and certainty and autonomy and relationship and fairness, I found that all the status related emotions that came to me, the remedy was almost similar. So the status related emotion, go for a jog, that's what I've learned. So go for a jog. So you have to find out what helps you overcoming those kind of things. And it is our responsibility to take care of those emotions. Because unnecessarily, they will be corroding our internal mechanism, the vital organs, the whole processes, the homeostasis, everything will get disturbed unless we take care of these emotions, which otherwise are not important. What happens if India loses? What happens if boss scolds me in front of others? We can have logic why you should not, but that should not is not going to help me as an individual. Let me take care of myself, take responsibility of my inner mechanism as an individual. So status, so similarly you have to map which is fitting into, which emotion is emerging from what of these five elements. So that's one I said. So this is called emotion or attention redeployment. So how to redeploy your attention on what when you are going through a disturbance in emotion? And redeploy where? That's one aspect. So this one, you have to find out where from the genesis is, where from has it emerged, that emotion, and look at what can be a remedy for it. The remedy you have to find out, typically I have checked with few others also, status, go for some physical activity, that helps. Endorphin secretion, I think, would help that way. So the next one is is how we see things. So it's called cognitive reappraisal. Cognitive reappraisal is how we see things differently. To explain this, let me narrate a small story. And it's like one day, say I was going in the car, and in fact, this happened to somebody I know. He was going, he narrated this, so I found this very interesting to share with others. He was going in a car, and the red light was almost imminent, green light here. He was about to cross it. An auto rickshaw from the left side, he came forward, and he also wanted to cross the red light, but the moment he was about to cross, he saw somebody from a distance is coming. So a couple of people, a couple of passengers who are coming from a place, usko do sawari mil jayega, so he stopped. Now this fellow is getting late for something. His son was there inside also. So the auto rickshaw has stopped. Green light about, in fact, green light also became red, and he was on fumes. So he started shouting at that auto rickshaw, what are you doing this, that? And it's not audible to him either, but he could see the thing. And suddenly, the son sitting beside, he said, why are you shouting like this? And the father says, kitna badtameez aadmi hai, pata nahi left se aake itna tez aake samne rakke aur rok liya mera green light, red light ho gaya, abhi main 5 minute late ho jaunga, we'll not get to the point, I think some to catch something, train or flight. So suddenly the young kid said something very unique, unusual, and this we can learn. He said, papa, aisa bhi to ho sakta hai, ye jo auto rickshaw yahan pe ruka, aur do log aake baithenge usme, ho sakta hai usko 10 rupaye milega, is 10 rupaye se ho sakta hai uska jo beta hai, ya beti hai, usko next meal mil jaye, ye bhi to possible hai. So this man, suddenly, which was otherwise an anger, fuming, suddenly translated into something called compassion. He felt this is a possibility. We don't know whether it's right, wrong, or whatever, but this is certainly a possibility that the next meal of the kid may be assured because of this delay of 2-3 minutes. So when he said, why not we see those possibilities? Because we don't know reality of why this man is driving like this, why that man is holding me like this, why that man is responding like this. Is it not our responsibility to see the possibility, and for our sake, it is for our own sake, we take the compassion route rather than the aggression route. And in that way, we tune our internal mechanism in a much better way. In fact, another story which goes in, like I was in Delhi, and मेरा एक फ्रेंड था उधर जो कि गाली बहुत देता था, कोई रास्ते में अगर रोड में इसको इधर उधर बिहेवियर करने मिला वो गाली देगा. सो वन डे ही वॉज ड्राइविंग एंड सडनली बाइक वाला ही केम फ्रॉम सिमिलरली फ्रॉम द लेफ्ट, ऐसे करके किया एंड टू सेव दैट बाइक फेलो ही टर्न एंड उसका जो सामने वाला बनेट है, ये है बड़गढ़ है, वो हिट किया पेवमेंट में, सो इट गॉट डेंटेड एंड ही वॉज सो एंग्री. Okay, I will follow this bike fellow. There are two guys. One is sitting in front, both without helmet. In Delhi, normally they get caught, but he was driving very fast. And he said, I will chase this fellow and catch him and thappad lagaunga. And he chased this fellow. Chala, phir aage dekha ek red light aaya, bola ki abhi kahan jayenge bachcho, red light se bach ke. But that fellow even crossed the red light without ignoring that red light. So he aur gusse mein aaya. And somehow, after some time, bola ki abhi to nahi milega, but when he went, he found there is a small little gathering, or few people are gathered there, and this bike fellow, both of them, are on the floor, niche raste pe pade hue hain, bike aise hi gira hua hai. Piche wala aadmi jo baitha tha, kafi, he was hurt. Front wala aadmi was crying. So he got down to, in fact, to fire him, got down. जैसे ही शुरू किया, ही वॉज क्राइंग लाइक चाइल्ड, मतलब मुझे जो भी हुआ है भूल जाओ, जस्ट टेक मी टू एम्स. मतलब एम्स मतलब क्या है, व्हाई यू वांट टू गो टू एम्स? ही सेड, माय डॉटर इज सफरिंग फ्रॉम डेंगू, आई डोंट नो वेदर आई कैन सी बाय द टाइम आई रीच देयर. सो ही वॉज सो, यू नो, ही फील्ड सो बैड अबाउट इट, ही सेड फ्रॉम नाउ ऑन आई विल नॉट से दिस काइंड ऑफ थिंग टू एनीबडी बिकॉज यू डोंट नो व्हाट इज गोइंग थ्रू द अदर पर्सन. We are seeing from our perspective So cognitive reappraisal is all about how we take care of other possibilities. Many a times we use some negative emotions because we presume something. So that presumption may be not in place. So how to use the possibilities? Many a time these possibilities can change entirely the aggression that we carry to compassion that we can have. So potentially we are highly compassionate fellows. As the recent research suggests, by birth we are good. So as we grow, maybe we don't know, we have not learned how to be more compassionate, kind, and forgiving. So that's what is creating so much of conflict around. We can probably think of these things. So reappraisal is about, this is one aspect as I said on the road. And reappraisal, typically if you see, these are related to fairness. That's what I normally, reappraisal works wonderfully well when we look at fairness, when we look at even some things related to uncertainty. So cognitive reappraisal, you can look at, you have to create a story for different events that happen. Promotion kyun nahi hua? Ya is mujhe koi aisa hurt kyun kiya? We can think of, maybe that person is not as evolved as, or as fortunate as I been. He has been, is not taught how to behave. So rather than getting angry about something, we can feel compassionate about people. So that's what reappraisal is about, how we see things differently. We have seen one clockwise and anti-clockwise thing yesterday. So many of us, we saw it clockwise and we missed out the anti-clockwise. So reappraisal is about how to see more possibilities. How to see more possibilities and choose the one which would make us more compassionate, more emotionally strong and resilient, rather than becoming agitated and angry. So this is cognitive reappraisal. Then we have something which doesn't appear to be giving any advantage to emotion regulation, but it is profound. It said it is more scientific in nature. It's called emotion labeling. Emotion labeling is about whenever we go through any emotion, let's say at this point in time, what emotion is going through, just I'll be aware of. When I'm angry, I just recognize that I'm angry. When I'm unhappy, I recognize that I'm unhappy. When I'm, say, anxious, I just be aware that I'm anxious at this point in time. It's more of a mindful way of living life. I'm just aware of being anxious, being angry, being happy, being excited, being thrilled, being kind, being forgiving or compassionate. So when I'm aware of it, what has been found out is two parts of the brain create a very strong linkage. There are many parts of the brain which are responsible for emotion. As yesterday I was talking about amygdala, there are a few other parts. Typically the front part of the brain, it starts learning what emotion and how to channelize that emotion. The moment I start recognizing the emotion, knowing ki ha abhi main gussa mujhe aa raha hai, ya abhi mujhe अच्छा नहीं लग रहा है, दुखी हूँ, या मुझे बहुत प्यार आ रहा है किसी से. द मोमेंट आई एम रिकॉग्नाइजिंग दैट इमोशन, माय ब्रेन स्टार्ट्स क्रिएटिंग अ न्यूरो पाथवे. दिस इमोशन, दिस इज हाउ इट फील. द मोमेंट द रिकॉग्निशन कम्स, द प्री फ्रंटल लोब, देयर आर टिपिकल फ्यू पार्ट्स ऑफ द ब्रेन व्हिच आर सेड टू बी वेरी यूनिक टू ह्यूमन बींग्स. एंड प्री फ्रंटल लोब वेयर वी हैव बीन टॉट फ्रॉम for ages, whenever you meditate, you take care of here. So this part of the brain is very unique, very human. There are a few other parts, but this is very human. This part recognizes the emotional aspect of the limbic system. And as it has been seen, the neural pathways are strengthened when we do this kind of practices, when we label those emotions, when we understand, recognize, appreciate those emotions. So we, that also, not just we recognize, we also understand what to do with those emotions. So this is emotion labeling. In some of our sessions, when we talk about the entire gamut of things related to emotion, the emotional intelligence aspect, there are four aspects of emotional intelligence, and the extension of how to channelize the emotion the best way, because it would take the whole day that way. But emotion labeling, and these five are more important for application point of view. So emotion labeling is the one where we start recognizing, knowing, and acknowledging those emotions, and slowly we start gain control of those emotions also. Unknowingly, it will come out automatically after some time. We start recognizing, gussa aa raha hai, gussa bhi ho gaya, lekin us samay I'm just reminding myself, I am angry, I am happy, I am compassionate, I am sad. So just being aware of that moment is very, very helpful. So far we have been talking about four things, all related to positive emotions. The fifth one is something little different. As we said that so many years human beings survived and survived not because of the positive emotions. It has been the negative emotions which have been surviving the whole race. नेगेटिव इमोशन अगर नहीं होता तो हम ना तो सांप से डरते, ना तो भालू से डरते, ना तो किसी और चीज से डरते, तो पूरा रेस ही खत्म हो जाता. सो नेगेटिव इमोशन इज एज इम्पोर्टेंट, अदरवाइज वी विल नॉट सर्वाइव. देयर इज अ बुक कॉल्ड द पैरानॉइड्स सर्वाइव, पैरानॉइड्स सक्सीड, ओनली द पैरानॉइड्स सक्सीड. पैरानॉइड्स आर द वन हु आर वेरी अप्रिहेंसिव अबाउट थिंग्स हैपनिंग अराउंड. मेरे साथ ऐसा तो नहीं हो जाएगा, वैसा तो नहीं हो जाएगा, बट दिस इज इम्पोर्टेंट और नॉट. Negative emotion that way is important or not?
It is
important. So we cannot just entirely ignore the negative emotions. We have to budget something for them. So this part is called